Philippine Senator Rizza Ontiveros reveals a supposed human trafficking scheme perpetrated by an alleged Chinese mafia. Ontiveros said the group recruits Filipinos through fake ads promising a job at a call center firm in Thailand. But they instead drag the OFWs to Myanmar and force them into cryptocurrency investment scams. 12 OFWs who fell victim to the scheme were rescued by the Foreign Affairs Department just over the weekend. Ontiveros now wants the Departments of Justice and migrant workers to look into the issue.
May namumuong masamang plano ang Chinese mafia na ito na gawing all-Filipino team ang mga scammer nila sa Myanmar at iba pang lugar dahil sa ating English proficiency. These Chinese mafias are making the Philippines an incubator of scammers.
An environmentalist urges the government to develop existing cities in the Philippines instead of converting farmlands into residential or commercial areas. Professor Tony Lavinia's call comes after Senators Rafi Tulfo and Cynthia Villar clashed on converting agricultural lands into subdivisions. Lavinia cites the city-state of Singapore as an example.
It's actually better cities. We don't have to expand our cities. We just have to improve our cities, better housing in our cities, more vertical, developing our cities, including for the poor and the middle class, as long as there are good transportation systems, as long as there are good water and energy systems. You don't have to convert new lands. I think the problem of our developers, and not just Senator Villar's company, but all our developers, they're just always looking for raw land instead of redeveloping land. Look at Singapore. You know, I mean, look at how Singapore just constantly redevelops.
Banco Central ng Pilipinas Governor Felipe Medalla continues to push for the expansion of digital payments and the shift towards a digital economy. However, he also told financial technology companies his slight inconvenient experience with some services. At the Index 2.0 Summit in Taguig organized by the FinTechAlliance.ph, Medalla mentioned how sometimes he finds it hard to pay via e-wallet at the mall. He revealed that sometimes paying cash is faster than opening an app. He mentioned that in the past two times experience, he said that cash was faster because he still had to input the amount on his phone. He said that he hopes all merchants will have a system where the amount to be paid is automatically imputed. He said that there are already many merchants who do that, but not all. Medalla also revealed an experience of a colleague who was late at the recent monetary board meeting. His colleague was stuck in traffic for over 2 hours at the expressway due to an issue with the RFID, which ideally would have made paying toll seamless and faster. Medalla said that all aspects of a system must work together to improve the process. All sectors must also complement each other because there might be no issue with the app, but if other partners are not in sync, then there may be an issue. FinTech Alliance Chairman Lito Villanueva said he heard the anecdotes of the BSP chief and vowed to make the FinTech systems better. He is also happy that Medalla himself is using some of the digital payments services and that overall he said that he expects the sector to grow even further, admitting that though there are challenges like internet connection, trust issues among older people and cyber attacks, Villanueva believes that the financial technology or the fintech sector will continue to thrive in the coming years.